I be getting to the money. Everybody mad. Think I'm getting too much money. Everybody mad.
What's up, Wealth Babe? Welcome back to the channel. I do want to plug a reminder here to let you know that you don't want to miss out on the 500 subscriber giveaway. I will be giving away $50 to the winner. To learn more about how to enter to win, you can check out the description box below, where there will be a section on 500 subscriber milestone giveaway. Or if you'd rather hear me talk about the criteria, you can watch the last two videos that I released on this channel prior to this one, so that you'll hear me explain how to enter to win. I will be announcing the winner on Monday, July 6th. So stick around and stay tuned for that video so that you don't miss the announcement if you are the winner. Now, if you are new, welcome to the channel. You can also enter the subscriber giveaway, but you must be subscribed. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and also click the bell to turn on post notifications so that you don't miss out on any wealth building content that's released here on this channel. And in today's video, I do want to talk a bit about how I go about picking stocks for investing. So let's go ahead and jump right into the video. So some of you may be wondering, where do you invest? What do you put your money towards when you start investing? Like, what stocks or what companies should you be investing in? And on this channel, I've said to look around your house and look at the things that have been that you've bought the most. But I want to dive a little deeper into this conversation so that we can make sure we're putting our money in the right places and with the right companies so that we can get the most of our money. Now, for me, when I started, I asked myself three questions, and those three questions were: one, what am I passionate about? Number two was, where do I spend most of my money? And number three is, or was, where do I spend most of my time? So let's go ahead and dive a little deeper into each of these areas, and then I'll talk about why it is that I asked myself those three questions to figure out where I wanted to invest. So the first question, what you do is ask yourself, what am I passionate about? And make a list of everything that you're passionate about. Be completely honest with yourself, because you will want to make sure that you are listing items that you are really, really passionate about. And you'll see why in a second here. The second question you'll ask yourself is, where do I spend my money? And I'm gonna go back to the line I bang most whenever people ask me, where do I invest? What should I invest in? I always say, look around your house. Where have you spent your money? I feel as though if you've spent a lot of money with a particular company, then why not invest with that company? So under this question, list out the items that maybe are in your refrigerator that you like to eat most, or list out the items that are in your closet. What stores have you purchased from most? For shoes, what stores have you purchased from most for clothes? Notice some of those stores or those name brand items that are in your closet, in your refrigerator, or just even household goods, which sometimes, more than likely, they're under one big brand. So we'll get into that in a future video, but these are some of the things that you want to list under that question. The third question that you're going to ask yourself is, where do I spend my time? And under this question, you're going to be listing everything that you spend most of your time doing. The top two things that you should be thinking about for this question are, one, what do you do for work? Where do you spend the bulk of your day? And number two, What do you do for leisure? Your hobbies? What do you do when you're getting off of work? Like, where do you spend the most of your time? Now, let's go ahead and put these three questions together. We're going to talk about a quick exercise. So we're going to do a quick exercise, and the exercise is just simply going to be making a Venn diagram. The Venn diagram, if you don't already know what it is, I will put a image in the screen so that you'll have a picture of what it looks like. Now, for the Venn diagram, you're going to be making three circles, and obviously it has to overlap at some point because it's a Venn diagram. So for the three big circles, the non-overlapping circles, you're going to label each of these circles with one of the questions we just went through. So the first question you're going to put in the first circle, which is, what am I passionate about? The second question you're going to put in the second big circle, which is, where do I spend my money? And then the third circle you're going to label with the third question, which is, where do I spend my time? Now, the magic happens in this fourth circle, which is the overlapping circle, and you're going to label this circle, where do I invest? Now, this is the magic, because you'll notice that you should, if you didn't do this exercise, I do encourage you to take some time and spend some time on completing this exercise. But the goal here is that when you make your list for each of these questions, you should be able to pull out some things that overlap from each of these three questions. And those are the things that you're going to be putting in that where do I invest circle. So that overlapping circle, which is the final circle, and it should be probably the smallest circle. So now that you have answered those questions, the magic of it all is that you have, what am I passionate about? You have, where do I spend my money? And then you also have, where do I spend my time? Because you've answered all of these questions, the answers that you got that overlapped, that will go in the middle, will be your ideal investments, because you're going to know the most about these things. You're going to be really intrigued with these things, and you're not going to be bored, or too bored to, I should say, to an extent, because we're still talking about finances, and I know finances can be a boring topic, but anyway, you you're not going to be as bored if you are, you know, putting in this circle things that you're passionate about. So I'm hoping that you, when you make your list, you will have items that were in each of these circles that were similar. So those are the things that you should be investing in, and you should be doing your research in when it comes to picking stocks for investing. That's it for now, Wealth Babe. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And also, feel free to share it with your social media networks if you find that this video has been helpful, so that you can help someone else on their financial journey or their investing journey. And don't forget about the $50 500 subscriber giveaway. If you want to figure out how to enter, you can check out the description box below. There's going to be a section on the giveaway criteria. And I do want you to stick around, because you will need to see Monday, July 6th video, where I will be announcing the winner. So if you enter, don't forget to review that video so that you can figure out how to get your money. And as always, please remember that if you're not fully, truly, and totally committed to building wealth, then chances are you won't. Mwah.